Greetings. I was asked to do a lesson on that old tune, Unclouded Day or Uncloudy Day, depending on what your source is. Nice little tune to play. And I was asked to do it with a noter, so I've got a reed bamboo noter here. And I've got a pick, and I'm using a yellow Hurdum for this. I never was much on the Hurdum picks, but for noter playing, they're very nice, I think. So, we're going to do that. We're going to try and learn this little piece, and we're going to take it real slow, and we're going to take it real easy. Now, there's two things I'm going to say before we start here. Number one is, I hold my noter with my index finger on the top. I think that comes from playing the steel guitar before I ever heard of a dulcimer. If you play with your thumb on top, that's fine. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with this. It's all good as long as you're able to hold the noter precisely and move it to where it needs to be for the next note quickly and again precisely. I'm playing a large-bodied John D Tignor dulcimer that Kevin Messenger restored for me. I'm pretty close to DAA, if not right on it. I'm mighty close, so we'll go from there. And I picked the DAA tuning for this for a reason, and that is that the lowest note in the song is the low A. So, because of that, we can use that on the open string and run the noter all the way to where we need to be to get it right. DAA is a nice tuning. If there's any interest, I'll do a chord version of this in DAA as well. And then a picked version in DAD. So, if you want something like that, just let me know. So, we're going to do this real slow, and we're going to take it a line at a time. Just one line at a time, very slowly. So, we're going to start off by strumming across all the strings open. Then our noter on one, three. Five, four, three, one, open. Got that? It's not bad, is it? Oh, one, three, 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 hold. Five, four, three, hold. One, hold, open. They tell me of a land far beyond the sky. All right, let's try this again. Do it with me. You've seen how it's done. We're going to do it twice more. We're going to do it real slow. Slower, forgive me. One more time with me. All right, that's the first line. Do what I do when I'm learning a new song. This applies to songs, particularly. Sing it. Doesn't matter whether you think you can carry a tune or not. Nobody's going to hear it but you yourself. So just sing along with it so that you get the phrasing right. Let's do the second line. It's almost like the first. We still have 0, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 7. Goes up. Went down on the first line, right? Now we're going up. 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 7. All right, so we've got the octave A now. Let's do it slowly together, just the second line, where we're going up after we get that. Oh, they tell me of a home far away. See? Oh, 1, 10, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 7. Do it slowly together one more time, and then we're going to put the first two lines in there back to back. All right, you ready to put them together? We're going to play through the first two lines, and we're going to play it slowly. And I'll call out the frets as we go. Ready? Now. 0, 1, 3, 3, 3, 5, 4, 3, 1, 0, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 7. How'd you do? I hope you did well with it. Now, notice the strumming that I'm doing. I'm using a back and forth motion as I strum. And sometimes I'm catching the bass in the middle string without doing the melody string. That's just to add a fullness to the playing of it. So pay attention this time to my left hand as we do it one more time. I kind of, when I play slowly, I kind of exaggerate the stroke so you can see where I'm going. However, when you actually play this, keep in mind you want to strum, and when you clear the strings, that's as far as you want to go. Sometimes when I strum, I'll rest these two fingers, my little finger and my ring finger, against the fretboard lightly. So I can't do this exaggerated motion. I can't do it because you don't want to be out here when you need to be coming back. Okay. All right, here we go.
Oh, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 4, 3, 1, 0, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 7.
How was it? Did you feel comfortable with it? Well, if you didn't, stop, rewind, and go back and do it again until you feel comfortable with it. That's the important thing. Let's go on to the next line. Did you catch anything on that next line? Did it sound familiar? Did it look familiar? Even more important. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. It's exactly the same as the first line. So if you have that first line down, you have two lines down, actually. So, let's just do this one more time, slowly. See how much you've learned already of this song? Now, here's the hard part. And it's not all that hard, but based on, we've been just staying right in here. In that area. Now we have to go from open, where we ended, all the way we have to go back to 7. Seven, five, three, four, five, three, four, two, one. Yes, that's adding a little embellishment. In that lovely land of unclouded day. So, when we come off the third line, where no storm clouds rise, move your noter to be ready to go to the 7th. You're open. Don't just leave your arm dangling out here somewhere or in this area. Move it down, because you're going to go right here to 7. 7, 8, 7, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 2, 1. Okay, play it with me. Just that line, starting on the 7th fret. 7, 8, 7, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 2, 1, 3, excuse me, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. All right. One more time, and then we're going to do the last two lines together, the third and the fourth of the verse. All right, here we go. We're going to do just the fourth line, starting on the 7th fret, and we're going to start now. Get it? See, it's not that bad. You just have to make sure you slide the noter. You're not picking the noter up and trying to move it. but you're sliding the notor across the strings. That's the thing. There are times when we have to pick the notor up, like going from open to seven. There are other times when you're going to pick the notor up from effect. You don't want the zing. But what makes notor drone playing interesting to me is that little zing we get in there. So now we're going to do the third line and the fourth line. Notice I hit a little slide there and didn't even use the pick. Let's do those two together and try that. There are occasions when you have these notes that are right next to each other where you can slide the notor without strumming the strings, the note will sound, and you'll be fine. So here we go. Last two lines of the verse. Start the chorus until you get the verse down. The chorus can be a little tricky in places, so you have to think as you play. You need to have this down. You need to get your slides right. You're picking up the notor right before you start on the chorus. Now, the chorus is not real difficult, so don't let me scare you there, but it's got more sliding that we do. And you're going to be going, hitting on the opposite stroke of the one you do first. So here we go with the chorus. And we're going to start it off on seven. We ended on three, the do and the scale. Seven is where we start. 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 4, 3. Let's do it again. 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 4, 3. Guess what? The second line is 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4. Isn't that interesting? That's almost identical, just not quite, a little different. But let's try that second line. We got 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4. All right, let's do it again. 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 5, 4. All right. Let's do both lines together here again slowly. Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, the land of the unclouded sky. Now guess where we're going. So let's do as much as we've done and make sure we've got that down. And then we'll be looking at the third and the fourth line. 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3, 4, 3. 7, 8, 7, 5, 4, 3. 5, 4. All right, back to our first line. Oh, 1, 3, 3, 3, 5, 4, 3, 1, 0, 7, 8, 7, 5, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 3. Got that? Yeah, that's the last two lines of the verse, or the last two lines of the chorus. So let's play the whole thing, and let's see if we've got it. We're going to play it slowly. I'll kind of sing it as we go to make sure that your tempo's right. Oh, they tell me of a home far beyond the sky. Oh, they tell me of a home far away. Oh, they tell me of a land where no storm clouds rise. They tell me of an unclouded day. 3, 4. Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. Have to apologize for some of that. I don't usually play the melody while I sing. I generally do a counter melody or an accompaniment of some kind, even when I'm playing with a noter. Well, let's try this one more time, slowly. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. I may not be able to answer them right away, but I will answer them if I can. Here we go. And we're going to take it just a hair faster, not much. Now I'm going to do 3 strokes and then we'll start. Seven, eight, seven, five, three, four, five, three, four, three. 7 8 7 5 3 4 5 3 4 2 3 Now, personally, I wouldn't play it any faster than this. That's just me talking now. You play it as fast as you think you should, or as slow as you can. Just get all the notes in there, hold them for the proper length, put a few embellishments in. Notice on some of those I slid the noter. Other times I picked it up. Vary it. And by picking it up, you don't have to pick it up like this. Pick it up just right off the string. Pay attention to your right hand, your strumming hand. Learn where you can hit the notes as you're just keeping a steady back and forth strum without having to break and change direction. Okay? That's the noter version of the Unclouded Day. Hopefully we'll get the chord version. There's not many chords that we use in it, so don't be... If you're interested in learning some chording in DAA, it's a good one to start with, because there's no real wild chords. So I hope you enjoyed it. More than that, I hope you learned something. And we'll talk to you later.